Hello and welcome to Yokayi Footy Shorts. My name is Megan Waters and I am joined by my co-host, brother, former AFL legend, Andy Cracker.
You're too kind, Megsy. Thank you, my sister. Always great to see you. Let's get stuck into it.
There was a lot of football that we need to cover in such a short time, but I want to start with the Richmond Football Club. How good was it to see their pressure back to the fierce brand of football that we know and love?
Yeah, it was absolutely brilliant. Started by this man, Morris Rioli Jr., and it filtered through the team to be able to close down the time and space of the Sydney Swans. We know how well they use the footy, but they just didn't have their time and space to be able to play their usual game. And obviously, the Tigers got their first win of the season.
They did indeed. I think the Tiger Army would have been going to bed feeling very happy last night. But that is why this week's Yokayi Moment goes to Adam Uze, the first win for coach of the Richmond Football Club, and he had a Gatorade shower post-match in the rooms. Incredible scenes and things that we love to see. So that is why it's this week's Yokayi Moment, brother.
Lovely to see you, and I can tell you from experience, them showers do sting the eyes, Megs.
Now, it was a weekend of upsets. The Pies handed the Brisbane Lions another loss at the Gabba. The Melbourne Football Club got up against Port Adelaide in Adelaide. So, yeah, some big upsets this weekend.
Jack Viney's 200th as well, so it was great to be able to see the Melbourne train continue to cruise along very nicely. And what about your Bombers, Megs?
Jeez, the Bombers. See the Bombers fly up, up. Jakey Stringer, he was a hero. I was biting my nails at this point of the game, but absolute great scenes. And good to see the Bombers get the win. Also, Jakey Stringer, it's always that he seems to put on a show just as contract negotiation conversations come about.
Now, it was a beautiful finish, 55 metres out late in the game, to be able to get the chockies on the long Easter weekend. Beautiful work from Jakey.
There was plenty of good to celebrate, but unfortunately we have seen another shocking injury. Wayne Malira, we will not see him for the rest of the 2024 season as he's been ruled out with that ruptured patella tendon, brother.
Yeah, unfortunately, since he's had to deal with a lot of injury through his career, missed a lot of footy in 2021 through some stress fractures, so he understands the journey, what rehab is and sort of what it looks like. So hopefully and no doubt he's going to get support from the Adelaide Footy Club, friends and family, and us mob here at Yokayi Footy Shorts, brother. Wish you all the best in your recovery and hope to see you bigger and better in season 2025.
Gather Round, it has arrived. Gather Round 2.0 this weekend. It is going to be an incredible weekend of football in Adelaide, and we're so excited to see First Nations artist Elizabeth Close. She's a Pitjantjatjara, Yankunytjatjara artist, and her art is going to be across all of the Gather Round collateral. So always really special to see our storytelling and artwork celebrated, and what a great round to showcase it.
Absolutely, sis. It's absolutely beautiful artwork. Gather Round in Adelaide was outstanding last year, so let's hopefully see that is the case this year as well.
Now, we just want to take a moment before we wrap up to send our love to Eddie Betts, Anna and the kids. They were the target of some vile racist abuse over the weekend, and we're going to take a moment to see how Eddie Betts responded.
To see that someone actually got out of their car and at 8:40 at night to drive to my house and yell abuse at my kids over the fence. I think this one hits a lot harder than all the racial abuse that I've had over my years. And that's because it's directed at my kids with such hatred. And to everyone at home, if you're watching this, please have conversations with your kids, your families, your friends. Have those uncomfortable conversations, because that's the only way, like I said, that we're gonna move forward in this nation.
Geez, that's hard to watch back. And I mean, I don't have kids, brother, but I know you're a girl dad of four beautiful daughters, so that must really hit home for you.
Yeah, it certainly does. And even looking at Eddie, you can see the pain in his eyes when he's speaking about it. And when it comes to your children and they're subjected to vile comments like this, it absolutely breaks your heart. And seeing the vision and watching Eddie's young fella run inside after hearing those comments, it absolutely pulls on your heartstrings, and it just makes your blood boil as well. It's it's disgusting behaviour, and we've got to understand, and what Eddie spoke about, that racism is taught. You're not born a racist, so we've got to make sure that you're having those conversations within your group of friends, within your household, to be able to make sure you respect one another, you treat each other with respect, and it's not that hard to do. So racism, I believe, is a public health issue, and it continues to do. And we'll just give credit to the way that Eddie's been able to handle himself so gracefully in these moments, which is hard to talk about, and especially with your children. So us mob here at Yokayi Footy Shorts are sending Eddie, Anna and the family nothing but love and support, and wish you all the best, and hopefully you're all going all right.
Well said, brother, and you're right. It really is a testament to the character of Eddie Betts. He's an absolute superstar and an icon, and we absolutely love you. And thank you for all that you do for our mob. That's it from us at Yokayi Footy Shorts this week. We'll see you back again next week.